All-Stars like it was last year. The NRL All-Stars got away with the game 28 points to 12. And as per usual, Sports News First ventured into the sheds to speak to the players. Well, we're here with Benny Barber. And Benny, mate, you got a try, first try for the Indigenous boys tonight.
Yeah, it's a shame it came at that time and how much we were down, but no, I was pretty excited to get one out of the way and would love to get a bit more.
Obviously a disappointing result, but there was no lack of trying from you boys at all, was there?
No, you definitely couldn't take away the effort was always there. It was just they were better than us on tonight, and we'll be back next year ready to try and win that trophy back.
It's your first time in this side, obviously very honoured to get selection.
Oh, definitely, mate. It was a big honour for me to get selected, just not for myself, but for my family and the people that care about me. So hopefully I can improve on that and get picked again next year to enjoy this great weekend.
And for many of us rugby league fans, it was the first chance that we got to see you playing a bit of fullback. You look pretty comfortable there.
Yeah, I've done a bit of work all through off-season and everyone at the Bulldogs has helped me out. And I was pretty lucky at night to play with some of the best halves in the world. And I'm sure they made me look way better than probably how I played. So, no, it was definitely great to play with Jono and Princey. And when you're the fullback outside them, they're definitely going to make you look good. So, yeah, I give a big rap to them.
Did you feel it easy enough to chime in?
Yeah, definitely. They're both good communicators and they made my job a lot easier. When they wanted me somewhere, they definitely let me know earlier rather than later, and it helped me a lot.
And what about the crowd tonight, mate? There was times there where it was deafening, the noise.
Yeah, there's a few times at fullback when I was yelling out, I don't think they could hear me, so I did a lot of pointing. So, the Indigenous community enjoy their footy and they're going to cheer for the whole 80 minutes when we're representing that jersey. So it was a great night.
Sports News First is joined by Jamal Idris. Jamal, mate, last year this time you pulled out last sort of minute. How'd it feel to get out there on the field?
Just felt good, you know, with the support and knowing your parents are on the field and that, and your family and that, screaming their head off. Some of them you haven't even seen for years. But, you know, I got to see them after the game and that, so, you know, I felt good.
It was obviously a disappointing performance, but there was no lack of trying from you boys.
Oh, 100%. You know, you can try as much as you can, but if it's not coming off, it's not coming off, and that's just how football is. So, basically, we've got to take into consideration everything that's happened through the trip, and we can learn from that and hopefully come back bigger and better next year.
Now, you've been keeping a secret for the whole year. You said that last year you were able to play, but you chose not to play because you didn't want to let the teammates down. Can you tell us a bit about that?
Well, basically, I ended up passing my fitness test, but I did it with pain. And one thing I don't want to do, you know what I mean? It's for our people. I don't want to, you know, be on the field and be injured and let the boys down, you know what I mean? So I decided to step out, you know, because I knew I wouldn't be able to perform at 100%, even 90 or 80. So, you know, I had to take into consideration what's best for the team.
Despite the result, you saw some family and friends out there. Were they still just as proud as if you, you know, got the points tonight?
Yeah, 100%. You know, they were cheering their heads off. It was my nephew's birthday and he came up for the game and that. So everyone was jumping over the fence, giving me hugs and, you know, I got pictures with them and that. And I haven't even seen one of my cousins, Jade, for about 3 years or so.
And what are you planning to do with the jersey? You know, back to your mum's lounge room, or is there going to be somewhere else that you're going to hang it up?
Oh, I just actually bought a new unit in Paris, so that'll be framed and chucked up on the wall, hopefully.
Beautiful. Good stuff, mate. Well done. Cheers. I'm Nathan Ryan, and this is Sports News First.